said it to you before.
Yes.
the bar, so we have the numbers.
I'm not my
Dear Schleid, good pious, and then good God will always protect you. I will look down on you from heaven and hear you. Thereupon she closed her eyes and departed. Every day the maiden went up to the mother's room and wept. She had good eyes and good food. When winter came, the snow was spread, the white sheet was red. By the time the young son had drawn the water in, the man had taken the money. Robin had brought them and went into the house of two daughters, a beautiful and fair face, a fly and a black heart. Why began a bad time for the first time? Is the stupid goose to sit in the party? They said. He who wants to eat bread must earn it. I took the garbage and wench. They turned up the old grey hat and put a cold grey bed on him and gave her moon shoes. Just look at the bright greenness. How decorated she is in fine and white and leather in the kitchen. There she had to do the hard work from morning to night, get up before daybreak, carry water, light fires, cook and boil. Besides this, the sisters did everything. Did her every imaginable woman in church. They walked her, emptied her plates and lentils into the ashes, so that she was forced to sit and pick them out again. In the evening, when she had worked and she was weary and had no bed to go to, she had to sleep by the hearth in the cellar. And as on that point, she always looked dusty and dirty, and they called her Cinderella. It happened that the father was once going to the fair, and he asked his two stepdaughters what he should bring back with him. Beautiful dresses, said one. Pearls and jewels, said the other. And you, Cinderella, said he. Father, break off for me the first branch which knocks against your hand on the way home. So he bought beautiful dresses, pearls, and jewels for his two stepdaughters, and on his way home, as he was riding through the green thicket, a hazel twig brushed against him and knocked off his hat. Then he broke off the branch and took it with him. When he reached home, he gave his stepdaughters the things they wished for, and to Cinderella he gave the branch from the hazel bush. Cinderella thanked him, went to her mother's grave and planted the branch on it, and wept so much that tears fell down on it and watered it, and it grew and became a handsome tree. Thrice a day Cinderella went and sat beneath it and wept and prayed. The little white bird always came on the tree, and if Cinderella expressed a wish, the bird threw down to her what she wished for. It happened, however, that the king gave orders for a festival which was to last 3 days, to which all the beautiful young girls in the country were invited, in order that his son might choose himself a bride. When the two stepsisters heard that they too were to appear among the number, they were delighted, called Cinderella and said, come our hair for us, brush our shoes, fasten our buckles, for we are going to the wedding at King's Palace. Cinderella obeyed, but wept, because she too would have liked to go with them to the dance. She begged her stepmother to allow her to do so. You go, Cinderella, said she, covered in dust, and dirty as you are, and you would go to the festival. You have no clothes and no shoes, and yet you would dance. As, however, Cinderella went on asking, the stepmother said at last, I have emptied a dish of lentils into the ashes for you. If you have taken them out again in 2 hours, you shall be with us. The maiden went through the back door, into the garden, and called, you tin pigeons, you turtle doves, and all you birds beneath the sky, come and call me to him, the good into the heart, the bad into the hall. Then two white pigeons came down by the kitchen window, and afterwards the turtle doves. At last all the birds beneath the sky came whirring and crying in, and lighted amongst the ashes. And the pigeons nodded with their heads and began, pick, pick, pick. And the rest began also, pick, 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 and gathered all the good grains into the dish. Hardly had 1 hour passed before they had finished and all flew out again. Then the girl took the dish to her stepmother and was glad and believed that now she would be allowed to go with them to the festival. But the stepmother said, no, Cinderella, you have no clothes, you cannot dance. You would only be laughed at. As Cinderella wept at this, the stepmother said, if you could pick 2 dishes of lentils out of the ashes for me in 1 hour, you shall go with us. And she thought to herself that she most certainly cannot do that again. When the stepmother had emptied 2 dishes of lentils amongst the ashes, the maiden went through the back door, into the garden, and cried, You tame pigeons, you turtle doves, and all you birds beneath the sky, come and help me to pick the good into the pot and the bad into the crumb. Then two white pigeons came by, the pigeon loaded, and afterwards the turtle doves. And at length, all the birds beneath the sky came whirring and crowding in and alighted amongst the ashes. And the doves nodded with their heads and began to pick, 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 pick. And the others also began to pick, 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 and gathered all the good seeds into the dishes. And before half an hour was over, they had already finished and all flew out again. Then the maiden was delighted, and she believed she might now go out into the wedding. But the stepmother said, "All this will not help you, but it's ridiculous, and you cannot dance. We should be ashamed of you." On this, she turned her back on Cinderella and hurried away with her two proud daughters. As no one was now at home, Cinderella went to her mother's grave beneath the hazel tree of night. Shiver and quiver, little tree, silver and gold thrown down over me. Then the bird threw down a gold and silver dress down to her, in slippers embroidered with silk and silver. She put on the dress, rolled the bowl, and went to the wedding. Her stepsisters and stepmother, however, did not know her, and thought she must be a foreign princess, for she looked so beautiful in the golden dress. They never once thought of Cinderella, and believed that she was sitting at home in the dirt, picking lentils out of the ashes. The prince approached her, took her by the hand, and danced with her. He would dance with no other maiden, and never let loose of her hand, and if anyone else came to invite her, he said, "This is my partner." She danced till it was evening, and then she wanted to go home. But the king's son said, "I will go with you and bear you company," for he wished to see him beautiful maiden in the world. She escaped from him, however, and sprang into the pigeon house. The king's son waited until her father came, and then told him that the unknown maiden had leapt into the pigeon house. The old man thought, "Can it be Cinderella?" And they had to bring him an axe and a pickaxe that he might hew the pigeon house to pieces, but no one was inside it. And when they got home, Cinderella lay in her dirty clothes among the ashes, and a dim oil lamp was burning on the mantelpiece, where Cinderella had jumped quickly down from the back of the pigeon house and had run to the little hazel tree. There she had taken off her wooden clothes and laid them on the grave, and the bird had taken her away again. And then she had seated herself in the kitchen amongst the ashes in her dry gown. Next day, when the festival began afresh, her parents and stepsisters had gone once more to Cinderella and to the hazel tree. And said, "Shiver and quiver, my little tree, silver and gold flew down over me." Then the bird threw down a much more beautiful dress than the preceding day. And when Cinderella approached the wedding in this dress, everyone was astonished at her beauty. The king's son waited until she came and instantly took her by the hand and danced with her but her. When the others came and invited her, he said, "This is my party." When the evening came, she wished to leave, and the king's son followed her and wanted to see into which house she went. But she sprang away from him and into the garden behind the house. Therein stood a beautiful tall tree on which hung his magnificent hairs. She clambered so nimbly between the branches like a squirrel that the king's son did not know where she was gone. He waited until her father came and said to him, "The unknown maiden has escaped from me, and I believe she has climbed up into that pear tree." The father thought, "Can it be Cinderella?" I had an axe brought and cut the tree down, but no one was on it. And when they got into the kitchen, Cinderella lay there amongst the ashes, as usual. She had jumped out of the tree and taken a beautiful dress to the virgin of the hazel tree and put on a great arm. On the third day, when the parents and sisters had gone away, Cinderella went once more to her mother's grave and said, "Shiver and quiver, my little tree, silver and gold flew down over me." And now the bird threw down to her a dress which was more splendid and magnificent than any she had yet, and slippers were gold. And when she went to the festival in the dress, no one knew how to speak her astonishment. The king's son danced only with her, and if anyone invited her to dance, he said, "This is my partner." When evening came, Cinderella wished to leave, and the king's son was anxious to go with her. But she escaped from him so quickly that he could not follow her. The king's son, however, had employed a ruse, and had caused the whole staircase to be smeared with pitch. And there, when she ran down, had the maiden's left slipper remained stuck, and the king's son picked it up, and it was small and dainty and all golden. Next day, next morning he went with it to the father, and he said to him, "No one shall be my wife, but she is filled with golden sea fits." Then were the two eldest sisters glad. They had pretty feet. The eldest went with the shoe into her room and wanted to try it on, and her mother stood by. But she could not get her big toe into it, and the shoe was too small for her. Then her mother gave her a knife and said, "Cut the toe off. When you're a queen, you will have no more need to go on foot." The maiden cut the toe off, forced the foot into the shoe, swallowed the pain, and went out to the king's son. Then he took her on his horse as his bride and rode away with her. They were obliged, however, to pass the grave, and there on the hazel tree sat the two pigeons and cried, "Turn and peep, turn and peep. There's blood within the shoe. The shoe, it is too small for her. Your true bride waits for you." Then he looked at her foot and saw how the blood was trickling from it. He turned his horse round and took the false bride home again and said she was not the true bride. Then this one went into her chamber and got her toes safely into the shoe. But her hand was too large. So her mother gave her a knife and said, "Cut off a bit of your hand. When you're queen, you will have no more need to go on foot." The maiden cut a bit off her head, forced her foot into the shoe, swallowed the pain, and went out to the king's son. He took her on his horse, as he tried, and rode away with her. But when they passed by the hazel tree, the two pigeons sat on it and cried, "Turn and peep, turn and peep. There's blood within the shoe. The shoe, it is too small for her. Your true bride waits for you." He looked down on her foot, and saw how the blood was running out of her shoe, and how it had stained her white stocking quite red. Then he turned his horse and took the false bride home. Again he said, "This is also not the right one. Have you no other daughter?" "No," said the man. "There's still a little stunted kitchen wench, which my late wife left behind, but she could not possibly be the bride." The king's son said it was to send her up to him. But the mother answered, "Oh no, she's much too dirty, she can't show herself." But he absolutely insisted on it, and Cinderella had him coloured. She first washed her hands and her face with him, and then she went and bowed down before the king's son and gave him a golden shoe. Then she seated herself on a stone, drew her foot out of the heavy wooden shoe, and put it into the slipper, which fitted like a glove. And when she rose up, and the king's son looked at her, recognized the beautiful maiden who had danced with him and cried, "This is my true bride." The stepmother and the two sisters were horrified and became filled with rage. He, however, took Cinderella on his horse and rode away with her. As they passed by the hazel tree, two white doves cried, "Turn and peep, turn and peep. No blood in this shoe. The shoe is not too small for her. The true bride rides with you." And when they had cried that, the two came flying down and placed themselves on Cinderella's shoulders, one on the right side, the other on the left, and remained sitting there. When the wedding of the king's son was to be celebrated, the two false sisters came and wanted to get favour with Cinderella and share her fortune. When the betrothed couple went to the church, the elder was at the right side and the younger at the left, and the pigeons pecked out one eye from each other. Afterwards, as they came back, the elder was on the left and the younger on the right. And then the pigeons pecked out the other eye from each of them. And thus, for their wickedness and falsehood, they were punished with blindness.